Okay, students, so we are seeing computer graphics today. In computer graphics, we will be seeing scan conversion algorithms. So in this scan conversion algorithms, we have point, how to draw a point on our screen. Then we have line generation algorithm. After that, we have circle generation algorithms. So we will be seeing how this point, line and circle gets painted on our computer screen. As we know, our computer screen is divided into a number of pixels, where we have an array of pixels like this. And if we have to draw a point, that means we have to fill a pixel like this. So that means we are filling a point. A point is also known as a pixel in my computer graphics. So we'll be seeing in detail how do we fill these points, how do we fill these, how do we draw a line, how do we draw a circle on my screen. So we'll be seeing point algorithm first. What does a point fill means? A point fill means on a particular screen I have to fill a point. So how does a point gets filled? We have just drawn one pixel, so that means I have filled a particular point. So similarly, if I ask you to fill, let's say 3, 2, I want to fill a point as 3, 2, what I can write down? Paint 3, 2, or I can have any function name which is like fill pixel 3, 2. So what is this 3, 2 means? So our screen can be considered as a plane, a 2D plane or a 3D plane, but let's see a 2D plane. So our screen can be thought of as a 2D plane, where we have a x-axis and then we have a y-axis. So as we know from the coordinates, this point would be 0, 0. So I need to move 3 steps ahead in x direction, and after that I have to move 2 steps ahead in the y direction. So let's start filling 1, 2, 3. So this is my third x. Then we have to move 2 levels up for the y axis, then I have 1, 2. So what is this? This is my 3, 2. I filled a pixel with coordinates given as 3, 2. Now let's see the next important algorithm, which is line scan fill algorithm. How will you draw a line on this screen which is divided into an array of pixels? Sorry, I've just rubbed it. So let's see, I have something like this. Okay, so this is a screen. If I ask you to draw a straight line, how we can do it? It can be done in a multiple ways. So I can fill. How do we in general draw a line? If I have to draw a line on a plain paper, let's say we do not have this grid or this pixel structure, how do we draw a line? We take a point, we know, okay, these are the 2 points and we have to draw a line. So if you have ever observed, how do we draw it? We are on this point, we try to move next, like if I am at this point, which point I will fill? next. Which point I will fill? Next. Which point I will fill? This. So like that I keep drawing a line to the point, to the destination point. In a similar way, we draw a line in a similar way on our computer graphic screen as well. Let's say if this was my starting point and this was my end point, how will I start drawing the line? I'll just fill next pixel. I will fill the next pixel. I will fill the next pixel. I will fill the next pixel. So like that, I will get an whole line. Sorry, I have not filled it properly. So you can get this line. Okay. So what was the observation from this manual algorithm that we have just discussed? That we are at some source point and we have to draw a line till my destination point. How would I do that? I will just calculate the next possible pixel location and I will fill it. So at every step I will calculate the next pixel location and I'll keep filling that and will soon reach to the destination point. It seems easier that if I have to draw an horizontal line like this, it is easier that I'll just move one step ahead in my x direction. Similarly, if I have to draw a vertical line, I will just move into the, let's say this was my starting point and this was my end point. So what I'll do, I'll calculate next, I'll fill it, I will keep filling it. Similarly, slowly I will, if you will see from the distance, you will see that I have a vertical line generated on my screen. So what was the algorithm here? I am at a point, I'll just calculate the next location in the vertical direction and I'll keep moving to the destination point and soon I'll get a line formed on my screen. So this was easier that we are just moving one step in a one direction. But let's come to, so what were the cases we discussed? Horizontal line. Then I had a case two. Let's say vertical line. Now let's come to third and the complicated case, which is an inclined line with some slope m. Okay, so let's say if I have to draw a line like this. Okay, so let's say this is my starting point and this is my end point. I was given, okay, these are two starting, this is one starting point and this is second destination point, and now you have to draw a line. How would I do that? So think about it. How will you do it? There is nothing like a horizontal or vertical line. There is not a straight line which is going to get formed. So what pixel will you choose? Will you choose this pixel? Will you choose this pixel? So around this pixel, there are like three pixels which you can choose. 1, 2, 3. So one is above to this pixel. One is ahead of this pixel. And this one is in the diagonal to this pixel. So we have to come up with some algorithm which can help us in designing, in drawing this line from one point to another point. So that is why we are going to discuss our upcoming line generation algorithms. So I hope the problem statement is clear, why we are actually going to discuss these algorithms.